Too big.
When I first started skating and I dreamed of being a professional skater, I couldn't even fathom what 20 years was. You know, like I was only 11 going on 12 years old. I hadn't even lived 20 years yet. So I never thought about like being so far into a career. I just thought of in the moment, I just want to be a professional skater now. One saying that my dad actually told me a long time ago when I was younger, he said, what got you there will keep you there. You know, and he was trying to prove the point of me to like, just because you think you made it, doesn't mean it's time to take it easy. It means it's time to keep it going. I always liked skating contests. When I was a kid, I used to skate castle contests. It's like Little League for skateboard. I like the different challenge. I, of course, obviously love street skating, and I love the challenge of pushing myself to do new tricks that I've never done, working the mental battle of like trying a trick for hours and working through that. I love that. But then in a contest, I love the challenge of right here, right now, one try, do or die, make it happen, you know? That also is exciting to me. Like, do the best thing you can do, but like right now. One try. That's like, gives me a little like a, I don't know, like a little buzz. Like, okay, let's do this. I like that.
Here we go. Switch, kick flip, fast.
I didn't think when I was starting to skate, oh, maybe one day I can be on Nike. Like, never even thought about it. It wasn't even a thought. It was nowhere on my radar that was even something I could think about dreaming of. That opportunity came to me out of nowhere, you know, so God just put that one in my lap to be sponsored by Nike when I got approached to ride for Nike. And I was like already skating my signature shoe with my last sponsor. I already had samples of shoes with my name on it. I'm already skating it, you know. Like just seeing my name on a shoe. I mean, my dream when I started skating was to have a signature board and signature shoe. To me, that's fully completing the pro skater dream, you know? So if I didn't get a shoe, that like, I feel like my dream would have been incomplete. So my manager was talking to them, working out, negotiating. He said, okay, here's what they want to offer. Here's what the terms of the deal are. I'm like, yeah, all that sounds good, but like, what about a pro shoe? What about a signature shoe? She's like, they didn't mention anything about it. So she went back, talked to Nike, called me back, said, they're not planning to do signature shoes. I was literally just like, nope, I'm perfectly happy already where I'm at. I wasn't planning on leaving. I just was like young and stubborn and stuck to my guns. I literally think about that story and can't believe, what if they just said, okay, nope, what would have happened? And like, what would SB been like now? Like, who would have been that guy that they would have gotten? I don't know, it would just be some like, alternate reality that I'll never know. But I'm just grateful that they came back and they believed in me that much, and there we went, 10 signature shoes later. There was only, I forget what the number is, like 5 to 7 guys in all of Nike in every sport that has gotten 10 shoes. And I'm the only one of them who's not a basketball player. If I ever got to hang out with every other guy who has 10 shoes on Nike, like just be my little short ass just standing there with these big like, amazing super athletes. it went from like first time I sent somebody my sponsor tape, I got sponsored the first time. I gave my friend Steve Vanasco, he rode for this company called Status, which was a sister company to this company called DNA Skateboards. Steve's going down to San Diego one day to go visit the Status warehouse. I ask him, hey, do you think you can give them my tape? He gives him my tape. He calls me from San Diego the next day, like, yeah, we want to put you on AM for DNA Skateboard. I was just thinking, maybe I can get flow and I can get like 3 boards a month. That's like, that was my goal. Like, I can get, like, no, we want to put you AM. We want to give you ads in the magazine, send you to Tampa AM. I'm like, what? Like, out the gate. And I wrote for them for like 9 months. And during that time is when Heath was doing his Logic skate video magazine. And I filmed with Heath, and he was skating a lot with Ryan Denman. And Denman was like, yo, this kid's good. I got to talk to Kareem about him. And got me on City Stars. I ended up, you know, rolling with Kareem. This is like around the time when like the street cinema video was supposed to come out. Is it ever going to come out? It's kind of like equivalent to everybody waiting on Dr. Dre's album, you know, Detox. Like, everybody's like, when's Dr. Dre's album? He's still working on it. That was kind of the same energy the City Stars video had. Like, everybody's like, when's City Stars going to have a video? When's Kareem's part going to drop? We want to see everybody's part. And I got on during that time, you know, and then we ended up making the video, and I was in that video that everybody had been waiting on, that I had, since I had started skating, been waiting on myself. Next thing you know, I just am going skating with Costin and Atiba. Like, I already had knew them. I was on S, you know. So I was already skating with them often as they would allow me to come around. I wanted to come around. And then Eric Costin, my hero, my number one hero in skateboarding. Yo, so what's up? You want to ride for girl? And here I am, just straight to pro status on girl. Wasn't an am, didn't, like, it was just straight to pro on girl. One point, me and Eric had all of the same sponsors. My hero, I'm with him on every single same sponsor. It all just worked without a hick. I look back and I thank God every day, like, I can't believe that. It really just went like that. And then, you know, I get a call one day from Danny Way. He's calling me. He was in the hospital too. He just had some surgery. But he was like, yeah, I'm in the hospital, blah, blah, blah. But anyways, we're bringing back plan B. But if we don't get everybody that we want, we're not gonna relaunch. That's what I remember telling him. Like, if you don't do this, we're probably not gonna do it. And like, at this point, I was like, I don't know, some of my gut told me I had to do it. I had to do it. That was great. 8 years I was with plan B, and that was epic times. Got to the point where I felt like, wow, like, maybe I can have my own brand and have something to contribute in skateboarding, as far as having a brand and starting a brand in skateboarding and having something that could last longer than me. Having primitive be looked at as one of like the most sought after brands that lots of people would like to be a part of. Like, that's really crazy to me. Like, very proud of, you know, Primitive and what we've built and the team that we have. I feel like our team, in my opinion, is just such an epic team of skaters. And I hope they all really realize how special they are and like really savor this time, this era we're in. Cause like, if anything this 20 years has taught me is it goes fast. I get really emotional if I think back about it in a good way, in a happy way. Like, it literally, it couldn't be more of a perfect story. Every dream sponsor I ever wanted, I got to ride for them. Even ones that I didn't know, that came later, that I didn't even know were an opportunity, I got to ride for, I got to be part of and learn from and like travel the world with my heroes, my literal heroes. I would be in my backyard skating sometimes and like be actually picturing like, I'm skating with Costin. Like, he's standing with me, like, you go. I would be picturing that in my mind. Like, skating in the back of Albertsons, like, I'm skating with Penny right now. Like, I'm gonna back him up. In my mind, he'd be, all right, he's gonna do a frontside flip. Okay, I'm gonna back him up on the frontside. Like, I'll be having these little, like, sessions in my brain with these guys. The fact that 20 years later, I'm still here, I'm healthy, I still got a lot left in the tank and a lot more I wanna do, so this is crazy. This is really still my job. Like, it's still my job. It's crazy, yeah. Yeah, that's tight.